one to go signal. Skyler Marler outside front row of the 257. 17 of Brad Skinner on the inside of row two. Outside the second row of the 98, it'll be Eric Hickerson. Third row, Scott Cook on the inside of the 11. Outside the 302 of Robert Stutz. Fourth row, Tim Boucher. Car number 15. Field bunching up in turn number three. Here they come off the fourth turn. They pick up the pace. Green flags out. We're racing. The pole position, Vic Hill takes the lead. Here comes Skinner in the 17 up into second. Outside of him, it's Marler in the 257. It'll be Skinner grabbing that second spot with Marler in third, side by side for the fourth and final transfer spot. Working on the outside in the 98 car. It ought to go three wide for fourth on the outside. Skyler in third, now moving up to fourth. Eric Hickerson of the 98 car. Scott Cook on the outside looking in. He's in that fifth spot. He's got to move up one more spot to make the show. He looks to the inside of Hickerson. Off a two. Can't make the move. It's still Vic Hill out in front. Brad Skinner in second. Scott Marler in third. Eric Hickerson fourth. Scott Cook in the fifth on the outside looking in. Up on the halfway point. Five down, five to go. It's still Vic Hill out in front with Brad Skinner in second. Third is Skyler Marler, and now the fourth place car, Eric Hickerson, has put some distance between himself and the fifth place car of Scott Cook. Vic Hill takes a six car length advantage down the back straightaway into turn number three. Skinner so far been unable to move up and challenge Hill for the lead. It's still Skyler Marler in the 257 holding down third with Eric Hickerson fourth at car number 98. Now Tim Boucher beginning to make a move up through the field. Boucher up to fifth and charging hard as he tries to close in on Hickerson in the closing laps. The battle for the fourth and final transfer spot in turn number one. Boucher looks to the inside. Hickerson will hold him off down the back straightaway into turn number three. Boucher right down on the bottom of the racetrack in turn number four. White flag in there working the final lap. The battle is for the fourth and final transfer spot. Vic Hill will take the win in car number 47. It'll be Brad Skinner in second. Marler will finish third. And it's Hickerson holding off Tim Boucher for the fourth and final transfer spot into the main event. Number two, 10 laps in length. Top four go on to the main event. Field bunched up and ready to go. They're in turn number three. Looking for the green flag this time by. It's out there on it. We're racing. Aaron Ridley grabs the lead. Don't go three wide for the lead off of turn two. DJ Myers in the middle of that sandwich. The 44 car, Randy Todd down on the bottom. Aaron Ridley hangs on to the point. DJ Myers settles into second. Randy Todd will hold down the third spot, looking to the inside. In the fourth position, it's David Severs in car number 18. And DJ Myers now looking to the inside of Aaron Ridley as they battle up front for the lead. It's still Randy Todd in the 44 car in third, right with him. Top three cars running together on the speedway. Off of turn two, they shoot down the back straightaway. Myers again will go to the bottom of the racetrack in turn number four. Four laps in the books. We'll be coming up on the halfway point this time by. Myers looking to the inside in turn number three. It's still Ridley on the outside, hanging on to the point. We're at the halfway point. Five down, five to go. Now Ridley gets a good bite up at turn number two. He'll pull Myers two car lengths down the back straightaway. Randy Todd still right there to challenge Myers for the second spot. It's still David Severs hanging on to that fourth position. Carnell Parker the third running in the fifth position. First driver on the outside looking in. 2 out of Chatsworth, Georgia. How about a nice round of applause for your second heat race winner, Aaron Ridley. Lineup, heat race number 3, 10 laps in length. Top three finishers in heat race number 3 go on to the main event. Rodney Wing on the pole position, brings him off the fourth turn. Green flags out, we're racing. Rodney Wing grabs the lead in turn number 1. Working hard on the outside, Tony Morris side by side in turn 3. Wing gets a little loose, turn 4. Morris gets loose on the high side, now 3 wide, down the front straightaway. Brandon Kinzer down on the bottom, battling for the lead with Wing and Morris down the back straightaway. Rodney Wing slides up in front of Morris. It'll be Kinzer going underneath Morris for second. Down the front straightaway into turn 1. Rodney Wing out in front. Brandon Kinzer trying to move up the challenge for the lead. Moving up into the third spot. It'll be Todd Hernandez in the T6 car. Morris back to fourth. Jason Wilson, car number 22, drives underneath Morris to take over the fourth and final transfer spot. Now Rodney Wing has got company up front. It is Brandon Kinzer, car number 18, moving up the challenge. Rodney Wing for the point. Down the back straightaway, they'll get the halfway signal this time by. 5 down, 5 to go. Rodney Wing leading Brandon Kinzer, Todd Hernandez, and Jason Wilson. It's still the 32 car now in the fifth spot. Jason Manley, first driver on the outside, looking in. Rodney Wing running the high side. Kinzer running the middle groove. Hernandez in third. Wilson in fourth. Rodney Wing making that number 11 car as wide as he can, and he's closing laps. 7 complete. Now 3 to go. Rodney Wing pulls out to a 2-car length advantage over Kinzer down the back straightaway into turn number 3. Kinzer trying to set up on the bottom groove of the racetrack. 2 to go, 8 down, 2 to go. Rodney Wing off a 2 down the back straightaway, still having a 3-car length for Brandon Kinzer. White flags in the air, 1 lap to go. Rodney Wing leads the field into turn number 1. He'll bring it off a 2. Now stretches it out to 5 car lengths over Brandon Kinzer. Rodney Wing brings the 11 car off a turn 4 to the checkered flag. It'll be Brandon Kinzer finishing second, Todd Hernandez third, and Jason Wilson finishes in the fourth and final transfer spot. Well, making the trip up from Meridian, Mississippi, the owner and promoter of Why Not Motorsports Park. He's your winner in heat race number 3. How about a nice round of applause? We call him the lug nut, Rodney Wing. Top 3 go on to the big show. Fourth and final heat race. For the SRS late models, we'll have the 8-car, 8-lap dash coming up next. With the top 2 qualifiers in the 4 groups, they'll battle it out. They've drawn for their starting spots. They'll battle it out for those first 8 starting positions in the big show tonight, paying $3,000 to win. So the field lined up and ready to go. Jeff Watson, the 11W car, off the pole position. Right foot Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth on the outside of the front row. Michael Asbury in the 360 car, inside row 2, outside second row, the F26. Here they come. Green flags out. We're racing. It'll be the 11 car taking the lead off of turn 2. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth on the outside. They'll go wheel to wheel through 3 and 4 up front for the lead. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth grabs the lead at the start-finish line. Now we've got trouble. So if everything looks good, we'll try it again this time around. Field lined up and ready to go. Here they come. Green flags out. It'll be Jeff Watson taking the lead in turn number 1. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth drifts way up high in turn 2. He's trying to get a run on Watson down the back straightaway into turn number 3. Watson will lead lap number 1 with Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth second. Mark Fields third. Michael Asbury in the 4th spot. So it's Watson, Hollingsworth, and Fields. Hollingsworth trying to get it wound up on the outside. Watson running the middle groove. final transfer spot. Asbury works down on the bottom. Can't make the move on Fields off of turn four. And still, Jeff Watson out in front. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth trying to pull alongside in turn three. Battles up front for the lead off of turn four. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth takes over the lead in car number 18. Drifts up high in two. Here comes Watson back on the inside in turn number three. Coming up on the halfway point, five down, five to go. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth with a two-car length advantage over Jeff Watson. Mark Fields in the F26 holding down third, but not for long. Here comes the 360. Michael Asbury powers around the outside to take over that third and final transfer spot. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth still running high, wide, and handsome in the 18 car. Out in front and beginning to put some distance between himself and the second place car, Jeff Wilson. Wilson now goes to the bottom, trying to get some traction to try to reel in Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth. He closes to within a couple of car lengths. Laps winding down, eight down, two to go. Hollingsworth now moves down a groove in turn number two. It's still Michael Asbury in the third spot with Mark Fields on the outside looking in. White flags in the air, working the final lap. Right foot, Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth down the back straightaway into turn number three. He'll bring it off of turn four, the checkered flag, and take the win. It'll be Jeff Watson in second. Michael Asbury comes home in the third and final transfer spot with Mark Fields fourth in the F26 on the outside looking in. Coming home with the win in heat race number four out of Northport, Alabama in car number 18. How about a nice round of applause for your winner, right foot Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth. Coming home in steam car and on the outside of row four in the T1 car out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, it'll be Todd Morrow. We understand the dash is going to be 10 laps, 10-lap dash, 8 cars, 10 laps. Here they come off the fourth turn, green flags out. And side by side, Ronnie Johnson on the outside getting that Chevrolet Performance CT525 wound up. Ronnie Johnson out in front, McCarter in second. He's battling with Josh Putnam in the 212 car. Putnam on the outside, Pierce McCarter on the inside. On the outside, it'll be Josh Putnam. Goes it ahead of McCarter up into second in turn four. Ronnie Johnson out in front. Now it's Josh Putnam in the second spot. Pierce McCarter in third. Now McCarter getting a challenge down on the inside. Chad Winkles in the 12 car. Winkles trying to slide up in front of McCarter, but runs out of room. McCarter hangs on to that third spot. Winkles still working on the bottom. Now Josh Putnam beginning to close in on Ronnie Johnson in car number 5. RJ down the back straightaway. Pulls out to a 3-car length advantage over Josh Putnam. It's Chad Winkles in the third spot. Pierce McCarter back to fourth. Now working to the inside of McCarter in the 16 car to be Daniel Miller. Riley Hickman brings the R1 car up into fourth as McCarter beginning to fall back through the field. Todd Morrow gets by him down the front straightaway. Morrow up to the sixth position in the T1 car. Ronnie Johnson still out in front as he completes lap number 7. 3 to go, 3 laps to go. Moving underneath Josh Putnam, Chad Winkles in the 12 car. They'll battle side by side for second. Winkles down on the inside, Putnam on the outside. 2 to go, 8 down, 2 to go. Winkles brings the 12 car up into second. Putnam fighting to hang on to third. Here comes Riley Hickman on the inside. White flags in the air. Riley Hickman battling for the third spot with Josh Putnam. Can't make the move in turn two. Checkered flag coming out this time around. In the win, we'll go to Ronnie Johnson. finishes second in car 12. Third goes to Josh Putnam. Riley Hickman in fourth. Fifth will be Daniel Miller. Sixth is Todd Morrow. Ray McElhinney in seventh. And Pierce McCarter will finish. starting 12 from Northport, Alabama. In car number 18, it'll be right foot Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth, starting 11th on the inside of row 6 in the 11R machine. Fourth row on the outside. These are your top 8 qualifiers. As we told you before, he won the dash earlier tonight, was light at the scales, so he'll start on the outside of row 4 in car number 5. National Dirt Late Model Hall of Fame inductee out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. It's the Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson. And all you great race fans here at Duck River Raceway Park, everybody up on your feet, wave your hats, your handkerchiefs, whatever you can wave. Wave at them, they're waving at you. Ladies and gentlemen, the cars and stars of the SRRS Late Model Series. Wave at them, they're waving at you. One of the most beautiful sights in all of motorsports, the four wide salute to the fans formation. Race fans, now we're going to see who the most talented race car driver is, because we're going to let him hold those flags for 40 laps and drive one-handed. Not. They're good, but I don't know if they're that good. What do you think, ladies and gentlemen? We're going to bring them by one more time. Should we drop the green? Let them hear it one more time. Here they come, four wide. Riley Hickman in the R1 car, the inside of row 2, the M16, Daniel Miller on the outside of the second row. Todd Morrow inside row 3, Ray McElhinney on the outside in car number 20. Pierce McCarter inside row 4. Ronnie Johnson, car number 5, on the outside of the fourth row. Fields bunched up and ready to go. Here they come down the back straightaway. Chad Winkles in charge of the field from the pole position. Field bunches up in turn number 3. Here they come off the fourth turn. Green flags out. We're racing. Winkles takes the lead off of turn number 2. He'll bring Putnam with him into second. Working down on the bottom. It's Riley Hickman in the R1 car. They come by to complete lap number 1. It's Winkles out in front. Josh Putnam running second. Here comes the 16 car on the outside. Daniel Miller. He'll move around the outside of Riley Hickman up into the third spot. Hickman now back to fourth. Todd Morrow running 20 machine, Ray McElhinney, and we've got caution on the Speedway. So in car number 47, and Rodney Wing running 10th in car number 11. So the field doubling up for the Dixie style double file restart. Race leader Chad Winkles out in front all by himself. Josh Putman has chosen the inside for the double file restart. That puts the third place car, Riley Hickman, to his right as the race leader. Here they come off the fourth turn. Green flags out and we're racing. Winkles leads the field off of two down the back straightaway. It's Putnam and Riley Hickman side by side. Riley working the high side, trying to get it wound up. Here comes Riley Hickman. He's on the move in turn number one. Riley Hickman pulls up alongside Chad Winkles in turn number two. Noses up in front, out the back straightaway into turn three. Winkles trying to get a bite off the low side of turn number four. They're wheel to wheel down the front straightaway into turn number one. Winkles with the advantage, but now Riley getting a run on him down the back straightaway in turn three. Putnam still back running in the third spot. Ronnie Johnson down on the bottom battling for fifth with the 16 car. Daniel Miller. Riley Hickman nosing out in the R1 car. It's still Winkles. Now Winkles will take the lead down the front straightaway into turn number one. Chad Winkles gets back by Riley Hickman to take the lead. Josh Putman still in third with Todd Morrow fourth. And now Ronnie Johnson up in the fifth spot in car number five. Caution flag out on the Speedway. Caution flag is out. Got one slow on the high side. Ray McElhinney, the 11 of Rodney Wing, and the 18 of Ronnie Lainsworth. So field doubling up behind race leader Chad Winkles. Riley Hickman has chosen the outside for the double end up accordingly. Here they come off the fourth turn. Green flags out. And trouble in turn number two. Putnam spins. He'll collect three, four more cars. So Josh Putnam, who restarted in the third spot, spins in turn two to bring out the caution flag. Again, chooses the outside, the new third place car. Todd Morrow will be to his left on the inside. Ronnie Johnson running fourth in the five car. Fifth will be Vic Hill in car number 47, lined up in that second row behind the leader. Field lined up and ready to go. Chad Winkles will bring him off the fourth turn. Green flags out for racing. Todd Morrow moves underneath Riley Hickman for second down the back straightaway. Hickman trying to get it wound up on the outside. Oh. caution flag coming out. So two laps past the halfway point is Vic Hill out in car number 18 after starting 12th. Seventh will be David Miller in the 16 car. Field doubled up and ready for the 22 lap in the books, 18 to go. Todd Morrow, your new race leader, brings him off the fourth turn. Green flag's out for racing. In the 70 car. Field getting the one to go signal. So Roddy Hickman choosing the inside for the double foul restart. Here they come. Green flag's out. Johnson in fifth. Here they come. Green flags out. Dusting off the outside groove. Can he make it? we got trouble in turn two. Caution flag coming out. Josh Henry spins the B00 car, the Boo car, over in turn number two. The lap shootout to the finish. Driver. Here they come off the fourth turn. Getting the one to go signal. Show and tell time, six to go. Here they come. Green flags out, we're racing. Three wide, four wide off of turn two for the second spot. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth trying to work underneath Ronnie Johnson in car number five. And they both get around Chad Winkles. So Winkles drops back to the fifth spot. Now Ronnie Johnson up to third. Johnson running third. He'll go to the high side along with Ronnie Hickman in the 1R car. Johnson looking to the inside of Hickman. Down the front straightaway. Ronnie Johnson and Ronnie Hickman wheel to wheel for second off at two down the back. This time by, there'll be three laps to go. It's Todd Morrow out in front. It's Ronnie Hickman in and Ronnie Johnson working the bottom in car number five for the third spot. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth fourth, Chad Winkles in fifth. Now Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth trying to close in on Ronnie Johnson in the closing lap. And now here comes Chad Winkles back to battling for the fourth position. White flag in the air, one lap to go. Todd Morrow into turn number one. Right down on the bottom. Ronnie Hickman trying to get a run down the back straightaway. Isn't going to happen this time. He'll go to the high side in three and four. Morrow sticks to the bottom. He'll take the checkered flag with Ronnie Hickman second, Ronnie Johnson third. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth will come home in fourth. And coming home to finish in the fifth spot. Todd Morrow, a hot day and some hot racing action here at Duck River Raceway Park. Some intense racing out there for the lead.
Yeah, well, me and Riley are good friends off the racetrack, and we had a good race. I commend him. I mean, we're side by side. I mean, you got to commend Bob. I mean, he's had this place 16 days, and it's good racing. Look at the crowd. I mean, you can see the walls. I mean, he's done a terrific job, and I'm sure he'll just get better with time.
How was the racetrack tonight? Some brand new clay here, and I mean, you guys were out there battling it out, three wide for the lead with you and Riley Hickman and Chad Winkles, and looked like it was really close here coming down the front straightaway when you squirted out of the pile to take the lead.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be in trouble because I actually qualified good and I hit the invert last, but you know, the racetrack was real racy. You can race top, bottom, middle, then the bottom got dominant there towards the end, but you know, it's 107 degrees outside. I mean, that's all you can do. I mean, it ain't their fault. I mean, it's good racing. It's going to happen. And, you know, yes, I appreciate them getting us a place to race and putting this deal on for us.
Well, tomorrow you're going to be back here again at Duck River Raceway Park, and it's going to be even a little hotter tomorrow. Like you say, 107 degrees today. It might be close to 110 tomorrow. What does that do to a racetrack, and how does that affect how you set up the race car?
Well, I mean, it's going to be slick because, I mean, no matter what you do, you can't put enough water on it. I mean, it's just, it is what it is. And, I sort of like the slick track, so I mean, that's why I like coming over here. So I think it worked out just fine for me. There's some people that probably wouldn't like it, but I like it just fine.
Well, Todd, why don't you take this opportunity to thank all the people that help you out with sponsorship on the race car and the people that help put you in the winner's circle here tonight.
Yeah, I couldn't do it without BMI and stealth carburetors and master belt race cars. And my grandma, she gives me the shop, and I mean, she helps me as much as she can. And I just recently got married in January, and she puts up with me, and I actually had to borrow money to come tonight, so maybe I can pay her back this next week.
Well, $3,000 will go a long way towards that, so congratulations again. We look forward to seeing you again tomorrow night.
Thank you. Thanks for fans for coming.
Todd Morrow, winner of night one for the SRS Super Late Models here at Duck River Raceway Park.